Needham native Suni Williams made history when she soared into space on Boeing's Starliner in June. Now she's adding space hours to her resume. She and fellow test pilot Butch Wilmore were supposed to head home after 9 days at the International Space Station. But during that flight, the astronauts discovered one of Starliner's 28 thrusters was faulty. NASA says they've used this time to collect data and learn from the issues. The question now, will the crew return on the Starliner sometime before September 24th or fly back instead on a SpaceX craft, but not until next February?
Butch and Suni are aware that we're always looking at contingency plans. I mean, this is a pretty common thing that we do.
Keeping the astronauts up there for a longer period of time isn't necessarily a bad thing.
Mike Massimino is a former astronaut who's worked with Suni Williams for nearly 30 years. He says she and Wilmore have done extended stays on the ISS in the past, and they train for this.
All indications look like they're going to be able to return them on the Starliner. I'd be surprised, actually, if that's not the case, because I think they understand the problem and they're learning more and collecting more data.
The water is pretty neat up in space. It'll stick to your toothbrush, and then you can drink it.
Suni is known for her incredible videos of what it's like to live in space. At this point, she's added another 63 days to the 322 days she'd already racked up. Now, Boeing has repeatedly said that the Starliner is safe for a manned mission back to Earth. But if NASA decides to switch to SpaceX, it means that a mission that was supposed to last about 9 days instead will last almost 9 months. We're live in Needham tonight. I'm Mary Salata, WCVB News Center.